गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून। ओके सो आफ्टर 2 or 3 minutes योर क्लास विल स्टार्ट। ओके लेट अदर्स जॉइन फर्स्ट देन क्लास विल स्टार्ट।
ओके सर।
Okay, so regarding the previous class, is there any query that RL series circuit, there its transient analysis, that regarding that portion? Okay, is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, then take the snapshot of this figure. Okay, and solve this numerical. Try to solve this numerical, and then send the answer in WhatsApp.
Sir, not visible.
Not visible. Okay. Okay, let me share it again. Maybe some problem is there.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। मॉर्निंग बीत गया।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर। आफ्टरनून। आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून। गुड आफ्टरनून।
आफ्टरनून।
ओके सो जस्ट गिव सम टाइम। यस नाउ आई होप द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल।
यस सर।
ओके ओके देन ऑल ऑफ यू टेक द स्नैपशॉट ऑफ दिस फिगर एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज गिवन। ओके and send your answer in the group, right? Try to do that. If not correct, no problem, I will tell you how to solve it. Okay.
Okay sir.
Okay, fine. So in previous class, so it is almost 1:07. Okay, so in previous class we studied up to this. Okay, everyone please mute your microphone because noises are coming. Okay. Everyone mute your microphone. Okay, now yes, this was the numerical that we discussed in previous class. Okay, and what was the main part? That this one, this graph is very important. Okay, this graph states that how the current is increasing, how the voltage is varying with respect to time. Okay, here this blue curve, I hope you can see this blue curve. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir. Okay.
This blue curve shows that maximum value of current that will pass through the resistor or through the circuit. Okay, and I told you that if t equals to 0, I equals to 0, so try to verify that from the graph. See, at t equals to 0, the I value is 0. Okay, and at t equals to infinite, the current is maximum, and this value is obviously depending on the voltage and the resistor, right? And this violet curve, or you can say the dotted curve, okay, this violet curve shows the voltage variation. Right. You can see at the when t equals to zero, the voltage is maximum across the inductor. Okay. And when time t tends to infinite, that means when the steady state value is reached, after that steady state value, the voltage in that resist, in that inductor is, across that inductor is zero. Okay, you can see here. Now, what is tau? Tau is the time constant. Always remember, tau is your time constant. And why this is very important? It is important because this time constant defines the characteristics of the circuit. Okay, how the circuit will act if you give 10 volt source? That tau will decide. Okay, if you give the current of 100 ampere, how the circuit will react, that will be decided by this tau. So this is very important term, do not ever forget. Okay, so based on this based on that equations, we solve this numerical. Okay, now what is the meaning of instantaneous current? That is the IT. So IT value you already know, correct? So at the time constant, that means when tau equals to, tau value is your, see, 20 millisecond according to this numerical. So at 20 millisecond, what is the current flow through the circuit?
Sir, yes? Students are waiting. Students are waiting.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, only one. Okay, fine. Okay, thank you. So here IT value you already know, that is Vs by R into 1 minus e to the power minus RT by L. Okay. Okay, so IT value for 20 millisecond, when tau value is known and its value is 20 milliseconds, so how much current will flow through the circuit? That is, you, that you have to calculate. Okay, so this value is 6.32 ampere. Put the value here in place of T. T value is already known to you. Put the value of tau. Correct. Now, so this numerical is very easy. If you can remember, if you remember the equations, if you remember the process, how to get that equation, you can easily calculate it. Okay, within a few time. Now, next numerical. Find the current in series RL circuit having R equals to 2 ohm, L equals to 10 Henry, while the DC voltage of 100 volt is applied. Okay. And what is the value of the current after 5 seconds of switching on? Right. That means, okay, one more thing. Here, see, the circuit diagram is not shown. So it's your work to show the circuit diagram. Okay. It signifies that you have understood the numerical correctly. Okay. So first, draw the circuit diagram. This is your R. That value is 2. Okay. Next is your inductor. Value is 10 Henry. This is 2 ohm. And what is the voltage? 100 volt. Okay. This is already given. Now you have to find what? The current equation. That means you have to find out what is the value of IT. Because this is not your ideal case, so that you can say, sir, this inductor will react as short circuit, the no maximum amount of current will flow through this inductor. No, this is real time, sir, real circuit. That means the inductor will present and current will increase gradually. That's why it is called the transient analysis. Okay. So here you have to find out the IT. Already you have found out in previous equations. Okay. So what is the equation? IT equals to capital I into 1 minus e to the power t by tau. Now, what is the capital I? Capital I is the maximum current that will flow through the circuit. So, what is capital I? It is nothing but the Vs by R. Current is your 50 ampere. Clear? Now, so what is the equation? 50 into 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. Next, calculate the tau. It is 5. Understand? Second, obviously. Okay, so e to the power minus t by tau. Tau value is 5. What is the t value? We still don't know. Okay, t is the variable. With respect to time change, this current will change. So that we are calling this the transient analysis. Okay, now. So the current after 5 seconds, now we are coming to the second numerical, second question, that what is the value of the current after 5 seconds of switching on? Okay, so after 5 seconds of switching on, that means here t will be 5, so e to the power minus 1, so 1 minus e to the power minus 1, so ultimately you will get, if you calculate, the value is 31.482 ampere. Okay, is there any query regarding this numerical?
Yes, no, sir. Or no?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So now next numerical is this. A coil having a resistance of 10 ohm, inductance of 1 Henry is switched on to DC 100 volt. Calculate the rate of change of current. Number one here at the instant of closing the switch. Okay. At the instant of closing the switch, what is the meaning of this portion? Can anyone tell me what is the meaning at the instant of closing the switch?
When the switch is closed.
That means what? What we have to find when t equals to what value?
Integral t.
T equal to?
Zero.
Zero, right. T equal to zero because, see, when the current will flow, when you switch, when you close the switch, then only the current will flow. So, when you are closing that switch, that is your T equals to zero. So, at that time, what is the value of the current flowing through the circuit? You have to find out that. Okay. That is your first question. Now, what is your second question? When t equals to tau. So, at this point, you have to tau value. Okay, how much second? And at that time, the switch is already closed. And how much current is flowing through the circuit that you have to find out? I, when t equals to tau. This one you have to find out. Okay. Try to understand what I am saying. Okay. If you cannot understand, ask me. Now, find out the steady state value of the current. That means what? When the current is at steady state condition.
T is equals to infinity.
T tends to infinite. Right. That is the steady state current. What is the meaning of steady state? Meaning of steady state is the inductor will be shorted. That is your steady state. Okay. What is your steady state current? Steady state current means this is your R, this is your L, and L will act as a short circuit. So that point is your steady state current, because after that the current will not increase. It is your maximum current. So you have to find what? Capital I. What is the value of capital I? Vs by R. So you have to find out this. Is that clear? Now, where I being the steady state current, already written V by R. Time constant value is L by R. So what is the value of L? 1 Henry. Value of R, 10 ohms. So T equals to 0.1 second. So first, you have to find out the rate of change of current at tau equals to 0.1 second. So equation of current, you already have. This is your equation of current. I equals to V by R into 1 minus e to the power T by tau. Now, what is the meaning of rate of change of current? That means you have to do the differentiation with respect to time. So that is done here. Look, di by dt. So d dt of, this is your V by R. Look, this is your Vs by R, correct? Or V by R. So what is the value of Vs? That is 100 volt. Look here. What is the value of R? 10 ohm. So put that value. Okay. So you will get 10. And after differentiation, you will get this di dt. 100 into e to the power minus t by 0.1 ampere per second. Okay. Now, look, this rate of change of current you are getting with respect to time t. Now, what is told? Calculate the rate of change of current at the instant of closing the switch. That means when t equals to 0. So put here t equals to 0. 100 into e to the power 0 by 0.1. That means e to the power 0. So it will be 1. Isn't it? So this value is 100. So that is done here. Look. At t equals to 0, e to the power, that exponential term will give us only 1, because e to the power minus 0, that means e to the power 0. So value is 1. So di dt equals to 100 ampere per second. Okay, next one, what we have to find out? We have to find out the rate of change of current at t equals to tau. That means at t equals to 0.1 second. So put that value. You will get this answer. That is 36.8 ampere per second. Okay. Next, the final steady state current already you had calculated. That is V by R. Here, the steady state current is V by R. Okay. So this is your final, the last answer of the final steady state current is 10 ampere. Clear? Okay. Do you understand the numerical? Is that okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Fine. Now, try this numerical at home. Okay. Just take a snapshot. So you have two numericals. Now, so take the snapshot of this numerical, try this, okay? Maybe you got correct answer, maybe wrong. I am not talking about the right or wrong. Try this at home, okay? Because until unless you try, you will not understand how the circuit will work. Okay, this type of numerical was given in previous year. So try to do this, okay? Now, let's solve some numerical. Okay, I am stopping here. Now I am sharing the screen. Just a minute. Okay, is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
No,
sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, no. Sir. Okay, yes, so yes, fine. So, previous day we solved this numerical, right? Now, today.
Sir, not visible.
Yes, sir, not visible.
Not visible, sir.
Just a minute, just a minute.
Visible, sir.
Okay, is it
visible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. So try to solve this numerical today. Okay. Yes. I am focusing on mainly numerical because numerical holds the maximum amount of marks in basic electrical. Okay. So try to solve this one. Okay, this is your 10 volt. Okay. This one is supposed 2 ohm. This one is 2 ohm. This one is 4 ohm. Okay. This one is 4 ampere. Okay. So you have to find out the power loss across this 2 ohm. Okay. This is your X, Y. So you have to find out the power loss across this point. Okay. So now you have the circuit diagram. Okay. So just a minute. This is your voltage source. Okay. Now give me some idea how to solve it. Which process? Because I am not mentioning you. Which process you want to follow? I just want to know what is the answer. If you do it like normal process. Okay, how to do it? Give one idea. How to solve it? You have 1 minute time. So think how to do it. No theorem I have mentioned here. Okay. I am giving you free hand to solve it. And I also don't want to know the answer right now because I also don't know the answer. I just come up with this circuit and just draw here. So I just want to know which process you want to follow. Tell me that. Okay, anyone, which process? Amit Singh, are you present?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so which process should I follow or should you follow?
Sir, I think Kirchhoff's law.
That is a law.
Yes, sir.
But which method you want to follow? Thevenin, Norton, nodal analysis.
Sir, nodal analysis.
Okay, then do the nodal analysis in your copy. Okay, I am doing also here. Check.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Whether it is coming okay or not. Right. So if you follow the node analysis, this point you should take as voltage V. Correct. Now, 10 minus V divided by 2. Correct. This is your incoming current. Okay. Clear. Now, which one is your outgoing current? This one is your outgoing current. So I am writing here V by 2 because this is your reference. So this is your 0 volt, correct? So V minus 0 by 2, that means you simply V by 2, correct? Now look here. Constant voltage, constant current source is present, 4 ampere. So here 4 ampere is your outgoing current, simply. So right here 4 ampere. Now you can calculate the V. Okay. So this will be simply 5 equals to here. You will get V by 2. Here it will be V by 2. So simply it will be V plus 4. So V value will be 1 volt. Okay, is that clear? V value will be 1 volt. Correct. Now, if V value is your 1 volt, so what will be the power loss in this section? The power loss will be P. V value you already have, so simple use V square by R or I square R. So if you have, if you want to calculate as I square R, then you have to calculate the current I that will, which will flow through this 2 ohm. Okay, that means 1 by 2. Clear. So now this will be 1 square divided by 2. That means 0.5 watt. Okay. Clear. So this is your answer, 0.5 watt. Okay, fine. Now, if I put here, instead of this current source, if I put here, just a minute. If I put here another voltage source, see, you can make one numerical circuit diagram easy. You can make it hard. Okay, so just a minute. This one, suppose the current is I0 and I am, okay, this portion I am removing. Okay, done. This one 0 volt. Okay. Now I have installed one voltage source, dependable voltage source. Okay. Is that okay? And I0 is the current flow through this circuit, through this path, through this branch. Okay. Now your work is to find out the current that will flow through this XY branch. Okay. I XY, try to find out and tell me what is the answer. Okay. Then I will start. You have 1 minute time. Do this numerical in your copy. Okay, try to solve this.
So in first question, V is equals to 1 by 2, no?
In first question means?
The first one you gave. Nodal analysis.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir, but I got V is equals to 1 by 2.
How you are getting V equals to 1 by 2? Mm.
10 minus V by 2 is equals to V minus 0 by 2 plus 4.
Yes.
In next step, we got 5 minus V is equals to V plus 4.
5 minus, how you are getting this? 10 by 2 minus V by 2 will be there. See, from here you are getting 5 minus V by 2, correct? Here you will get V by 2. Okay, just a minute. Okay, now is that clear? Abhua?
Yes, sir.
So I hope you found out where you did wrong. Right or wrong?
Yes, sir. At that is step 10 minus V by 2, I got 5 minus V. That step I got wrong.
Okay, 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 fine. Okay, no problem. Okay, so have you found out this numerical, this one, the updated one? Anyone? Try to solve the numerical, okay? Okay, fine. So I am doing this and you just follow up, okay? So now this numerical will be done here. See, here I am placing one voltage here. Okay, is that correct? So what is your incoming? See, I am doing every problem in nodal analysis. You can do this problem also in Thevenin, in Norton, in superposition. Okay, no problem. You can do it. Easy. Now, first is nodal analysis. Because only one variable is present, only two variables are present here. One is I0, because this one is a very critical variable because one dependable source is present. Another one is V here. Okay. So 10 minus V by 2, that is equals to I0. Is that okay to you? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So I0 value is known to you. Next, we are going to create that Kirchhoff's current law, according to Kirchhoff's current law, based on nodal analysis. Okay. So look, 10 or your incoming current, you can write as I0. That is your incoming current, right? And another incoming current is also present here based on this voltage, that is 4I0, correct? So 4I0 minus V divided by V. Is that okay? Step by step, try to follow.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes,
sir. Next, for the XY branch, V minus 0 by 2. Clear? Now try to create one equation of I0 and V. Or you can simply put the I0 value here also. No problem. You can put this value here also, but that will make the system a little bit complicated, right? Let's check whether it is getting complicated or not. No, it will not get complicated. Why? See, 4 is here, 4 is here. So it will cancel out, right?
Yes, sir.
I0 plus I0 minus V by 4 equals to V by 2. Correct? Now, from here you are getting 2 I0, okay, equals to V by 4 plus V by 2. So it will give you 3V by 4. Correct? 3V by 4. So from here you are getting V equals to...
V equal to 8, sir.
8. 8 by 3 I0. Correct? Now, what is the I0 value here? You are getting 10 minus V by 2. So I am replacing I0 8 by 3 into 10 minus V by 2. Clear? Now 2, 8 cancel out. It will give you 4. So ultimately you are getting 3V equals to 4 into 10 minus V. So I can write this one as 40 minus 4V. So ultimately you are getting V equals to 40 by 7. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Now, the V value you have, now calculate the current value that is passing through the IXY equals to 40 by 7 divided by 2. So it will be 20 by 7 ampere. Okay. Okay to everyone? Clear one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if the teacher is so clever that he is thinking, so what he will give? He will think that how much power is sending from this source. Can you find out? Each source is sending some power. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So now your work is to find out how much power this dependable source is sending. Can you tell me? Try to find out. Because there may be, it may be given. I don't know. Okay. Whatever question will be given in your exam, I don't know, you don't know, nobody knows. Okay, so try to find out the answer from each corner. Right. So my question is, how much power is sent from the dependable it will not take so much time.
So your voice is breaking.
Okay. Okay, maybe there is internet problem from my side or your side. Okay, I don't know. Okay, so which part you didn't listen, where or you cannot hear?
So from that one where you wrote PD.
Okay, P, that means I am trying to say you are seeing this dependable source, right? 4I0 voltage is present here. So I am asking you, you find out how much power it is sending. How much power this dependable source is sending. Now, is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So you yes, have sir. To find out how much power this dependable source is sending into the circuit. Right. So try to find out. If you get any answer, tell me. Okay, any method?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me what.
In current, we are solved by VA, by VA plus VB. That one is applicable here. With resistance, we calculate the amount of current. So in that, power is calculated by that one.
Okay, that means you know, see, you have the voltage V. Your V voltage is already known to you.
Yes, sir.
Now you, what you want to calculate?
Yes, sir.
Now you will calculate which value?
For each given resistance and each given power drop.
Okay. Here, V is already known to you, correct? So, V value is your 40 by 7 volt. Okay, it is already known to you, correct? Now, match with your answer. First, you have to calculate this voltage. What is this dependable sources voltage? So, first, to find the 4I0 voltage, clear? So if you are putting in place of I0, 10 minus 20 by 7 divided by 2, is that okay to you?
Yes sir.
Okay. So, 2, 4 will be cancelled out. It will give you 50 by 7, 100 by 7. 100 by 7 volt. It is your source value, source voltage, correct? This dependable voltage. Okay, please mute yourself. Your noises are coming. Okay. Now, what is the voltage value? This 4I0? This 4I0 value is your 100 by 7, right? So, how you are going to calculate the dependable sources volt power? It will be calculated by the voltage into current. See, how much is the voltage? 100 by 7 volt. Okay, so 100 by 7 volt. And how much current is going through this side? That is, suppose I dash. So you have to find out that I dash. And if you multiply that, then only you can say that this dependent source is sending this much power. Okay. Now, how will you calculate this I dash? The value V is already known to you. This 4I0 is also known to you. So your current value I dash will be 4I0 minus V divided by 4, correct? So 4I0 value is 100 by 7. What is the value of V? That is 40 by 7. Divided by 4. So this will give you 100 minus 40, that means 60. 60 by 7 divided by 4. So 15 into 4, that is 60. So 15 by 7. 15 by 7 ampere current is flowing through this path. Okay, this second arrow, double arrow, or deep arrow, this path. I dash current flowing value is 15 by 7. So now you have the current value and the voltage value. Now calculate the power. Power is equals to 100 by 7 into, this is 7, okay, into 15 by 7. That is your what? Okay. So this is your 1500 by 49. Okay. Now it's up to you whether you want to keep it like this or in decimal part. Okay. It's up to you. Okay. Now is the process clear,
sir,
to everyone?
Yes. Sir, the value of V should be 60 by 7, na?
Yes, 60 by 7 divided by 4.
There 4i0 wahan pe matlab 10 minus v, so value of v is 40 by 7 and you have written 20
yes,
by
sir.
7
40 by 7 20 by 7
no see here 4i0 value is what,
sir? 4 into 10 minus v by 2.
4 into 10, what is the
sir,
value
4
of
I naught equal to
what is the value of I naught? Did you get that?
So 10 minus V by 2.
Yes, if you calculate that.
Sir, so in the place of V, you have written V. 20 by 7. But it is 40 by 7, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just a minute. Let me clear that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, first you have to calculate the, for power calculation, what you need only voltage and current, right? Okay, do you have any class after this?
No, sir.
Okay, so if that no, extends sir. 10 minutes or 15 minutes, no problem, now.
No, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So this V value is...
So please provide your attendance link, sir.
Yes?
So please provide your attendance link.
Attendance, okay, just give your attendance in the chat box, otherwise the same problem will occur just like previous day. Some in some mobile it will open or some mobile it will not open. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just give your attendance in the chat box. Just you, if you write your roll number or if you write your name, I have your details, so no issue.
Okay, sir.
So give your attendance in the chat box. Okay, now look here, the V voltage is your 40 by 7. I hope it is okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, you have to calculate this 4i0 value. Okay? That is the voltage of the dependable voltage source. So, what is the value of 4i0? In place of i0, put the value 10 minus V by 2. 10 minus V by 2. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So from here, look, this is your 10 minus V. What is the value of V? 40 by 7. Okay, so I am writing here 2 into 10 minus 40 by 7. Okay, so this value is 30. So it is 60 by 7, right?
Sir, and you had written 100 by 7.
Oh, achha.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Very good. So, this value is 60 by 7. So, accordingly, find out the current. So, current value you can find out. I dash. That value will be... this problem is not given in any book. Okay. So, gave you this numerical. This numerical is not given. So even I don't know what value will come. So it's up to the calculation fully. Okay, now this is your 60 by 7. And what is the value of I dash? That is 4i0 minus V divided by 4. Okay. So 4i0 value is 60 by 7. Right here, it is 60 by 7 minus, what is the V value? That is 40 by 7. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, you are getting 20 by 7. So, 20 by 7 divided by 4, it will be 5 by 7.
5/7.
Very good, very good. So now calculate the power. What is the total voltage? That is 60/7 into 5/7. So it is 300/49. Is this the answer you are getting?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that means I just got bowled out by my own numerical. Very good.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I hope you got the clear idea how to solve the each term of any kind of numerical. Okay. In later classes, I will show you another forms of the numerical that may be given in exam. Okay. So in next class, based on the RL analysis, that means your transient analysis, we will solve some numericals. Okay. And already two numericals I gave you, right? Do you have that snapshot of those two numericals?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So try to solve that at home. And if you solve that, send me the snapshot in the group or to me. No problem. Clear?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So thank you, everyone. I am concluding today's class with this. And I hope today I got time to send all the details I discussed. Right. So
everyone, thank you, sir.
Attendance.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I have a doubt regarding the F1 lab assignment, sir.
Yes, please tell me.
Sir, there are 5 observations in the given PDF, but in the lab we took 3 observations. So how to put the rest of the 2 observations, sir?
No, just whatever observations we told you, that observations will be enough.
Sir, in the given PDF, there are place for 5 observations, sir.
Write 3 observations.
Okay, sir.
Any more query regarding lab or regarding this?
No, sir.
Sir.
Okay. Yes?
I have query. Sir, can you see the first homework again?
Yes, I cannot hear you. Please speak louder.
First homework question, sir.
What?
Sir, first homework question.
First question? Which question?
Which you have said to solve
homework. Sir, homework question, yes, he is telling.
Okay, homework.
I will snapshot. I will send.
Okay. Does anyone have that snapshot? Then send that in the group. All of you will get.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, is that Amita? Okay, you are getting that snapshot from the group.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so all of you give your attendance in the chat box. If given, you may leave the meeting. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, sir. Thank you.